perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. And I just can't imagine how
what
you
are you
could
doing?
Be. She's so sad, but so strong at the same time. And I don't understand how he could do that to her.
The first time I listened to this album, I think was 2 days after it came out. I had seen a couple things about it, you know. I had heard Driver's License, of course. I had seen the comparisons of Good For You and Misery Business, so I figured I'd give it a listen, see what it was like. I just turned it on in the background, didn't really pay much attention to it, and I really enjoyed it that time. This time, however, what I did was I sat down, I opened all of the lyrics for each song, I opened a notepad, and just listened actively and took notes on every song. So, let's go through each track, and then I'll give you my opinion on the album as a whole. Brutal. Love the intro to this song. Love that orchestral intro. I'm a sucker for stuff like that. I really like the Riot Girl sound of this album. I think it's really nice. It's refreshing. Something I did not expect to come out of this. It's nice. I expected more Paramore pop punky stuff, not Riot Girl. The distortion is good. It's got a good build in it. I like how it ends a lot slower and softer. Simple. Nothing special. It's a simple rock song. It's pretty consistent all the way through, but it's good. It's good. Traitor. This one's probably my least favorite on the album. First time I listened to it, I just thought, oh, this sounds very Taylor Swift. That is not a bash. It's just not my kind of stuff. Her voice is really nice in this. It sounds pretty Hayley Williams in this one, which is not a bad thing at all. Hayley Williams is one of my favorite singers of all time. Olivia Rodrigo has a great voice. I love the lyric, "I wish that you had thought this through before I went and fell in love with you." That is good. It reminds me of the classic breakup songs that we listen to. But reading through the rest of the lyrics on this, it's one of those songs I have to remind myself that she was 17 when she wrote this. I am not in high school anymore. I am past that. And it seems kind of sad and pitiful. That's fine, but this one is not for me. Driver's License. Okay, so this one came out first. It was the single. It was massive. Oh, huge song. The first time I heard it was actually a cover that I really enjoyed. So I looked it up and listened to the actual version. Really enjoyed it the first time through. In fact, I texted one of my friends and said, "Hey, listen to this. It's heartbreaking." And then I listened to it again and I was like, maybe not as good as I thought the first time. Once again, very, very high school breakup song. But the music in this is fantastic. The music is great. Super well produced. It really conveys that the heartbreak and the pain that she wants you to feel with her. It really does a good job of that. This is where Olivia Rodrigo's not just singing talent, but acting talent comes out, because she is conveying that pain so well. It's kind of beautiful how well this song portrays the overly dramatic, sad feeling that you feel when you're in high school and you go through a breakup that you look back on in 10 years and you're like, well, that was stupid. Yeah, it's kind of beautiful how well this conveys that. I'm sure if this came out when I was a freshman going through my first breakup, I probably would have had this on my playlist with Ocean Avenue and all of my breakup songs. The breakdown of this song lets me down every time. It's not as good as the rest of the song because it hits and it gets back to that background kind of stuff. I still see your face in the white cards front. And it just says, oh, time for more Taylor Swift. That's what it sounds like to me. And I just kind of get, I'm not excited for it when it happens. I'm like, oh, the good part of the song's done. But overall, good song, well produced, does what it's supposed to. One step forward, three steps back. This song, I like the piano in it. It sounded, when I first heard it, it sounded very Sarah Bareilles-y to me. Which I'm sure that's probably someone she listens to. I read an interview where she talked about her inspirations, and she didn't say that, but she would fit with some of the people she said, so I wouldn't be surprised. Once again, the lyrics are all right, but then she'll have one good line in there, and that's kind of how I feel about a lot of her songs. Is the lyrics, I'm like, okay, it's meh, nothing special, but then there will be one line that sticks out to me. Didn't realize this until I was looking at the lyrics and saw that Taylor Swift had a writing credit. Evidently, she interpolated the music from New Year's Day, the melody, and somehow it adds up to 13, because that's Taylor Swift's thing. She does Easter eggs, and I don't know. That's cool. I'm not going to downplay that. It really is. It's cool. She is using the music of someone that she really admires, and she is throwing Easter eggs in there, and that's cool. I like stuff like that. If I was a huge fan of hers, I'm sure I would love that. Reliant K did stuff like that when I was a kid, and I loved their little Easter eggs. So that's cool. It's a decent song. Deja Vu. Okay, this song I like more than I want to like. I really do. The breakdown is so damn good. It is. I love that synthy. Ooh. Yeah. The lyrics, not so much. I don't care about those. But the music in it is probably one of my favorites. This one or one later on the album are going for my favorite. Also, If he introduces a girl to Billy Joel using Uptown Girl, you didn't need him anyway. You find you somebody better. You hear me? Scenes from an Italian restaurant. That's an introduction to Billy Joel. Uptown Girl. No, you can do better than that, Olivia Rodrigo. I believe in you. Good for you. It's everywhere. I have people all the time come up to me and they're like, have you heard this? It sounds like the things you listen to. I mean, kinda. It's got that Misery Business comparison that everyone does. And it's good. I like the sound. I really liked it the first time I heard it. Now that I've heard it 1,000 times a week for the past couple months, not so much. Kinda tired of it. Oh, man. It's just everywhere right now. I think it's a song I will really appreciate in about 15 years when it's been a while, you know? I'll probably like it then. The chorus gets me every time, you know, you're listening to it, and even if you're like, I don't like this song. Because for you, you're unhappy and happy, did not make it a danger. But it's good. It's a good song. It's a bop. I hope people find the Paramore in it and then go seek out Paramore. Enough for you. It's meh. In the same way as Traitor, it just feels like a Taylor Swift song. It really does. I'm sure a lot of people like that. It is not for me. It's just kind of meh. The lyrics are just really sad until we get to the point when she's talking about how she'll find someone new and she'll be enough for them. I was like, ooh, we're turning it around. We're growing. We're learning from this experience. And then she says, and you'll be the one who's crying. And I'm like, dang it, Olivia Rodrigo. You had me going. And now we're back. We're back where we were. It's fun. Happier. This song has my favorite lyrics on the album. I love the idea behind Happier. Oh, it's such a good premise. It is. This one, I think these lyrics should stand the test of time more than anything else on this album. I think it is a great breakup song. It is the most universally identifiable, I think. Anyone of any age who is going through breakups can enjoy this song, I think. I like it. But that being said, this song pisses me off every time I listen to it, because we get a couple verses, and then she has that nice, sexy, low-toned guitar. I'm not a guitarist. I don't know the word for the way it sounds, but it's sexy, and it's my favorite sound of guitar. And then we never hear it again throughout the whole song, except in the background where it is mostly hidden by piano. Oh, it could have been a great song if it broke down and had more of that guitar. It could have been so nice. It would have been a nice build to it. It could have climaxed into it and just been would have easily been my favorite song had she done that. But I digress. Good lyrics. Jealousy. This song hits, and I'm like, ooh, not about the boyfriend, ex-boyfriend. Not about his new girl. Are we getting introspective here? Because we're talking about how we feel and how we're wrong to feel the way we feel. Maybe we're growing. Maybe we're learning. Maybe this is where this album takes a turn. It's got really good drums in the background. I like the guitar in the back, too. I like the way it sounds. It feels kind of Billie Eilish-y in certain points, and not in a copying bad way. I think it takes a good amount of inspiration from her, and it's good. I liked that. I think it does a really good job of expressing how we interact with social media, how we see the best of people, because that's what they put forward. And not the nitty-gritty, and that makes us feel kind of worse about ourselves just because we're not seeing what those people are going through. It doesn't blatantly say that, but I think it does a good job of showing that. This one or Deja Vu are probably my favorite. I don't know which one. Favorite crime. Damn it, Olivia Rodrigo. You had me going. Jealousy made me think that we had moved on from the sad girl whining about ex-boyfriend. Maybe this is where this album takes a turn. But no, we're back. We're back to that. But I will say, this, I really like the title. I like the meaning behind it. It's a great premise. It's a good metaphor. It's very, and this is going to sound a little this is gonna sound like I'm exaggerating, but it sounds that's kind of Eaglesy, not in the sound of the song, but in the writing style, because they had like lion eyes, like they did a lot of metaphors, stuff like that, and I like it in this one. It shows promise. But the downside of this song is that it hits. It is the second to last song. It sounds exactly like the rest of the songs. It has that behind it. And at this point, I'm tired of that sound when I'm listening to this album. I really am. I'm ready for something different. Hope you're okay. This one is different, subject-wise. I like the story it tells. I like the first two verses are really good. And then I thought it was going to build into something, and then it doesn't. It's just more of the same. So that was kind of a letdown. I think it would be a great song that probably the true fans of Olivia Rodrigo would hold as like a hidden gem, you know? Because I think if it had a good breakdown, good climax, after those first two verses, it would make it a all caps, like in my notes, great song. The album as a whole, it's a good enough album that I'm really nitpicking, honestly. It's her first album, and it's a good one. It's not for me, both age range and music style-wise, but it's a good album. I have talked myself in circles around this album, at first liking it and then convincing myself I didn't like it, and now I am coming to terms with I think I like it. The thing that gets me the most is the sound being the same all the way through and it not being cohesive, and I think both of those could have been fixed. The album would have been better for it had she added in between each song, you know, done some time changes, done some interludes, and made each song continue into the next, because the songs are already so similar that I don't think it would take much to make them just transition right into one another. And it's a short album, it's only like 35 minutes long, so I don't think that would be too big of an ask, and it would make it all feel better. It would make it seem more like a concept album, and it would probably make me enjoy it more, honestly, because you would look at it less like, oh, I'm still listening to this same sound in another song, and you'd be like, oh, this is all one song, and it's got some pretty good different sections in it. I'm not into the drama behind this. I know it's about What's-His-Face from High School Musical, and it's about What's-Her-Face from Disney, and I don't know, whatever. But the two songs that are supposed to be in response to this suck. I know what you say about me. I hope that it makes you happy. And it makes this album shine because of how bad those are. And I honestly, listening to a lot of pop music recently, which is not my genre, but I like the direction that this is headed in. It's more real. It's more sad. Olivia Rodrigo shows a lot of promise. I think she is probably going to be great. She's got a great start. She is showing some really good signs of good songwriting. Like I said, each song has a line in it that I'm like, oh, that's a good line. There's a couple songs in here that are just really good premises. I'm ready to hear more from her. She's so young. She's so new to the industry. I'm looking forward to what else she comes out with. This is a promising start. And she has my support. I'll listen to whatever comes out next. Sour by Olivia Rodrigo. Thumbs up.